Welcome to Impact OC, the only program showcasing the people and organizations shaping Orange County, with your host, Don Camber.
Hello, live from the OC Talk Radio studios at UCI's Beal Applied Innovation Center. I'm OC Talk Radio Public Affairs Director Don Camber with another great guest impacting our community in a positive way. Today, I welcome Community Legal Aid SoCal Executive Director Kate Marr. The organization provides advocates for justice in Orange and Los Angeles counties. Thank you, Kate, for being on Impact OC.
Thank you so much for having me on the program, Dawn.
Kate, I understand your mission is to help people fight injustice by providing compassionate, high-quality legal aid and advocates for stronger communities. How are you able to achieve this?
So we are the largest legal services provider here in Orange County, and we've actually been working in the county since 1958, when we were founded by an auxiliary organization from the Orange County Bar Association. And there are almost 650,000 people eligible for free legal services in our service area. We have about 120 staff, including 40 attorneys, about 45 paralegals, and two case managers. And we provide, what we really do is provide wraparound holistic services to clients in areas like family law, domestic violence, seniors, economic opportunity and stability. We also have a health unit, and we do a lot of work around housing and immigration. All of our services are completely free, and we also work with the courts here in Orange County to provide free legal clinics and legal workshops.
How does it operate?
So clients are generally, they come to us and are screened through our intake and assessment unit. And then there, through that unit, they are either provided, sometimes their issue can be resolved really simply with just some counsel and advice, or brief service like helping someone prepare pro per pleadings and walking them through the court process. But we also provide full scope representation, so full representation in court from the beginning to the end of a legal case.
Can you explain one case? Just walk us through a case to understand how it works?
Sure. So most clients come to us because they have one specific issue that is troubling them right in that moment and they need immediate help with. So for instance, we have a client maybe who's being evicted and they're coming to us to prevent losing their home and becoming homelessness. Most of our clients also have families, so it's not just the one individual client that we're helping, but they maybe have two or three kids that live with them as well. But what's interesting is that most clients that come to us, they're living in poverty and they're being impacted by so many different issues. And so it's really important to us that we treat clients holistically. So this client that comes to us with an eviction, we maybe in the interview process realize that she's also a survivor of domestic violence. And so we don't just stop with preventing the eviction. We want to make sure that we are reaching out and helping her with all of the legal issues that we have expertise in to make sure that that client is really set up for success. Because if all we do is address that eviction and we don't address the fact that maybe she is a victim of domestic violence and she has an abusive partner in the home, it's not going to do much good if we keep her in her home for 1 month, but it's not a safe place for her and her kids. So we really, through our screening process, are trying to identify all of the issues that the client has that we are able to help with. And what's really unique about our program is we also have case managers that work hand in hand with the attorneys and can help clients with some of the other issues in their lives that may be impacting their chances for success. So maybe they need emergency rental assistance. Our case managers can help them apply for that. Maybe they need help trying to find a job. They can help them with writing a resume. They can help provide court support for a victim of domestic violence and be there with them in the courtroom as an emotional support.
Now, during COVID, you probably got a lot of clients.
Yes. And actually, we've seen a huge increase, actually a threefold increase in housing cases particularly over the past 18 months, and also a big increase in family law and domestic violence issues.
So what makes a person eligible for your services?
So generally, most of our funding requires that folks be low income, which for most of our grants, that's at about 200% of the federal poverty limit. But we do have some sources of funding, for instance, our seniors unit that allows us to help people regardless of their income.
So how do they connect with you?
So primarily clients come to us through our intake and assessment unit. We have both a hotline and online intake, and folks can access us that way.
So do they hear that they're in trouble and they figure that to get free legal services, they'll go to you because they know they're eligible?
Right. And if we aren't able to help them for whatever reason, if they're not eligible or it's not an area of law that we handle, we are connected with most of the other social service agencies in Orange County and the other legal services providers. And we work really hard to provide them with, you know, a warm handoff to another agency that can help them. And if that doesn't work, then we also have connections with local lawyer referral services where we can refer them for help to find a private attorney.
And explain the staff you have to help these people.
So as I said, we have about 40 attorneys, about 45 or so paralegals. We're in the process of hiring right now, so those numbers are actually in flux as of right now. And then we have the two case managers. And then we have an admin team that supports the legal advocates as well.
Now, do the clients come to you in a certain place, or do you go to the clients?
So we are really try to be out in the community where our clients are. And so we have clinics in the courthouses here in Orange County, which is where most people who have a legal issue, that's sort of where they start. And we have a relationship with the courts where they will refer folks to us who are eligible for our services. We also have very close relationships with local social service agencies, community-based organizations, all of the domestic violence shelters in Orange County. And so we get a lot of clients through those agencies. Hopefully at some point we will be able to do more in-person outreach. We used to do quite a bit of that at the local senior centers and at the family resource centers here in Orange County, but obviously that's been cut back a bit because of COVID.
Funding.
Yes. We are very fortunate to receive funding from the Legal Services Corporation, which is a federal agency. And they get a allocation from Congress every year that is divvied up between all the legal aid programs in the country. There are actually 11 LSC-funded programs here in California, and we're the only LSC-funded program in Orange County. We also get quite a bit of funding from the state of California through the state bar, and then we get local government funding. We also have some private fundraising and some foundation money that
now,
we receive as well.
What would you say the majority of your cases are about? Are they domestic violence, eviction? What would you say?
I would say right now, because of the sort of eviction crisis that's going on as a result of the pandemic, the two biggest areas of cases that we're seeing are housing, eviction, domestic violence type cases.
So how are you able to handle this? A person's facing eviction. Can you actually keep them in their home? What would you guys do?
So we do our best to keep them in their home if that's a good solution for them. We do everything from, like I said, basic counsel and advice, because oftentimes people will call us even before an eviction proceeding is filed saying, my landlord is threatening that they're going to evict me. And we walk them through what their rights are and whether or not, you know, that is likely to happen and what they can do if they do receive paperwork. And then we also will prepare paperwork for them and go all the way through handling court cases with them. And we've been very blessed and lucky throughout the pandemic. We created a new partnership with another nonprofit legal services program here in Orange County that we're calling the Orange County Housing Justice Collaborative, where we're actually getting help from pro bono attorneys who work at local law firms or maybe in private practice solo. And they are volunteering with us one day a week to do these answer clinics where clients can come in. We do it completely remotely, and clients can come in virtually, so to speak, and get assistance from a private attorney filing a response to eviction pleadings. And then sometimes the attorneys will develop a connection with the client and actually go ahead and take that case all the way through representation.
So are you successful in preventing evictions?
Yes, we are. I mean, oftentimes in an eviction case, a success is preventing an eviction, even if the client ends up moving out, because a client doesn't want an eviction on their record. It makes it a lot harder for them to rent another apartment. So sometimes success in an eviction case actually looks like negotiating a settlement for the client to move out. But we also do fight evictions and take it all the way through jury trials at times.
And you also help victims of domestic violence.
Yes. So this is a cause that's near and dear to my heart. It's how I got my start in legal services. And so I'm really proud of the work that we do with survivors of domestic violence, especially with using case managers to really support them holistically throughout the process. So we're not just, you know, helping them with their divorce, but we're providing them with wraparound services that they need for their family to sort of help really stabilize their lives beyond just resolving a family law dispute or getting someone a restraining order. And I would say that it's some of the most rewarding work that we do. Seeing a client, go from a place where they really feel like they have no options and are really terrified for their kids and the future of their family and go to a place and go through the process and come to a place where they feel like they have a voice and they can speak up and they can tell their story about what has happened to them, and they can, you know, through the legal process feel like they're really like protecting their kids. That's why I got into legal services. And so I'm just thrilled that we're able to help so many clients through those issues.
What about the demographics of your clients?
So most of our clients are women. Most of our clients are people of color. I would say probably maybe around 40% are monolingual, non-English speakers. And as I don't know if I mentioned before, so we serve both Orange and Los Angeles
sure.
County. So the demographics are a little bit different
based on
the county. We really have made a conscious effort in the last several years to partner with trusted community-based organizations, because oftentimes clients from different backgrounds feel more comfortable going to an agency that they know someone in their community has used before, or sort of gets the stamp of approval from someone within their community. So that is something that we really worked a lot on before COVID and are continuing to do, although it has been a little bit harder during COVID just because of not being able to go to local community centers and things like that. But we still do have those partnerships, and it's really been a big help to bringing in clients from different parts of the county, because where our office is located is not necessarily always the most convenient to some of our client communities.
And where is it located?
We are located at 2101 North Tustin Avenue in Santa Ana, just north of 17th Street. But again, as I said, we do, we have clinics in the court. We work at the community court in downtown Santa Ana. We also have worked at community centers in Garden Grove and family resource centers in South County to make sure that we really are where the clients who are eligible for our services, where we're accessible to them.
So explain what happens when a potential client connects with you.
Right.
Who's the first person they would talk to as they move through a potential process?
Right. So the first person they're going to talk to is an eligibility screener, who basically goes through just a brief screening to make sure that they're actually eligible for our services. And then from there, they'll be passed on to one of our intake paralegals, who really gets sort of the in-depth details about their case. And just depending on the level of need, oftentimes, as I think I said earlier, it's something that can be resolved really pretty quickly over the phone. They just need a little bit of advice. They maybe aren't in legal proceedings. They just need to know what their rights are. Excuse me. And so sometimes it's resolved right there. Sometimes they need some help to prepare paperwork, but they don't necessarily need attorney representation. We can set them up for a clinic where it used to be that they came into the office in person, but obviously that's not happening right now. But we're doing virtual and remote clinics right now where they're set up to get help with filling out legal paperwork. And then they can take the legal paperwork to the court and they have instructions on how to file it and what the court process is going to look like. And then some cases that are particularly complex or fault in some of our priority areas, we will take for full representation. And at that point, if it is a case that we're going to take for full representation, and let me say, we wish we could give full representation to all our clients, but as I said, with 650,000 eligible people, there's no way with our staff that we could give full scope to everybody. So if they have a case that is in one of our priority areas and they are deemed, you know, a case that we want to take for full scope, they're then set for an appointment with an attorney in one of our substantive units.
And you take it all the way to resolution?
Yes. We take cases all the way to initial resolution and sometimes even through an appellate process if that's what is required.
And you also offer free workshops?
Yes, we do. We have, and those workshops, sometimes callers to our hotline who just need some help with pleading preparation, those are the people that will maybe be sent to one of our workshops. So we have workshops in partnership with the court. We do conservatorship workshops. We have workers' rights clinic once a month. We have, for some reason, I'm blanking on all of them right now, but if you go to our website,
which is
www.communitylegalsocal.org.
And you also deal with elder abuse.
Yes, we do, which is really a growing area of concern in Orange County, and I think everywhere, and something that really we are very concerned during the pandemic has probably spiked quite a bit, but some of those clients may not have access to the resources to get to our services. So we are very concerned about what the impact of that we'll see once the pandemic does come to an end. But we do help with elder abuse, both physical, emotional, psychological, and also financial elder abuse.
And what are some of the legal issues with elder abuse?
So oftentimes the legal issues are needing to get a restraining order against maybe a family member or someone who is a caretaker. Oftentimes there are the family member may be living in the home, and so sometimes it's needing help to get a restraining order that not only is going to protect the person but also remove the abuser from the home as well. And those are particularly difficult issues because parents, oftentimes it's a parent and a child relationship, and it's particularly difficult for parents to come forward and seek restraining orders against their children.
Well, also, how does someone who's elderly know that they could get your services so that they can get the help?
Right. So that's why we partner really closely with all of the senior centers here in Orange County, and we also work closely with Adult Protective Services, and they will make referrals to us.
Do you have a lot of volunteers?
Yes, we are very, very lucky to have pro bono attorney volunteers. We have law students who do a lot of volunteering for us through actually one of our biggest partners is UCI Law School. We're so grateful to them. But we also have volunteers in our other departments as well. We've had volunteers who help with marketing and communications, volunteers who've helped with our ops department. And we definitely could not do the work that we do without volunteers.
Explain what they can learn in the process.
Well, there's a lot that they could learn. Not only, I mean, obviously the volunteers on the legal side could learn about substantive legal issues, but we also take, it's really important for us that we provide trauma-informed services to our clients, and many attorneys who don't work in the legal services world, and even some of them that do, really aren't familiar with what that is. And it's a tool, it's a skill set that folks can use, you know, in any of their relationships. And so we're really proud to train our volunteers in trauma-informed service delivery as well. And so that's just one thing that they could learn in addition to sort of the substantive areas of law.
Please give us the website again.
It is www.communitylegalsocal.org.
Thank you, Community Legal Aid SoCal Executive Director Kate Marr, for being on Impact OC. And I thank everyone for tuning in. I'm OC Talk Radio Public Affairs Director Dawn Camber. Have an impactful day.
Thank you.
You've been listening to Impact OC, the only program showcasing the people and organizations shaping our community. Right here on Orange County's only community radio station, OC Talk Radio.